Hey guys, what's up? It's Joey Cubes here. In today's video, I'll show you how to solve a master morphix. So basically, this is the second third video in my tutorial of the morphix puzzles. And this will be on the 3x3 shape mod into a tetrahedron, the master morphix. Now, I have these two right here. These are both Shang Xiao. This one's been discontinued, and this one's the newer stickless bright version. But since the light makes this really bright, I'm gonna use a darker one. It works just a bit better. So, I unboxed this, like I said, in a previous video. It feels pretty much the same as this, a bit lighter, and it's pretty nice turning. But other than that, let's just get started then. Okay, so basically, you can see that this puzzle is three layers. This is a layer, another layer, and the last layer. And you can see that this is a centerpiece, because it never changes its place. These are edge pieces right here. And these are corners, pretty obvious. But what might not be obvious are these are corners, and these are corners. So let's get into scrambling this puzzle. I'm just gonna do some random moves. And yes, this puzzle does shape shift. Scramble it just a bit more. Almost there. This is a pretty good quality master morphix also. Okay, I'd say that's about good. So next, what you want to do is you want to align the centers on all the sides. So you want to align the yellows. So see how this yellow is aligned with this yellow? You want to align here, this. And you have these yellow centers aligned. This is just turning the center, so it's pretty intuitive. So I wanna, these are already lined up. I wanna line these blue up. Just see if you have to turn this blue up. And we have that. And now we wanna turn the red up, and the red's done. So we can see we just have the centers matching. Okay, so now that we have the centers matching, we wanna put the cross in. So we'll look for a center. Let's use this center. So I want to put a red in here. So I'll look around for a red edge and see, oh, this red edge could go in there. So we'll turn the bottom layer and see, can it go up here? Yes, it can. But the thing is, it turns this center off. So what you want to do is turn it away, turn the center like this so it lines up, and then move it up. Okay, so now let's move on to the next red edge. So the next thing you want to do is look for a red edge. So we can see we have one down here. Now we can see it needs to go up here. So that means we need to line it up with one of the centers. So let's see, if we line it up with here, will it go up? Yes, it will. You can see it matches up, making our cross. Now we have to make a green one. So we'll look around for a green edge right here. And see, I'll show you how to do this one step right here. So it may be confusing, where if you can't line it up like this, what you need to do is put in the bottom layer right here, insert it into a slot where you're making your cross, and then take it out the other way. Okay, now that you've done that, you see that it would now line up with this center. So we mash it up with this center right here. So that's matched up, and then turn it off. And if you have an edge that's slipped and can't go in there, that's what you always have to do. So we'll look for the next one. See? This has to go up here. Now, One note is you should know how to solve a 3x3 before attempting this. So we can see. Can it come up to the top? Yes. So that's good. So we'll turn the center around so it lines up right here and put it up. Now you have successfully created your cross. See? We have this and this. You can imagine it as a cross like this. Okay, so now what we want to do is insert our corners. So we'll start off with these one-colored corners. So these one-colored corners, like you said, you want to just insert them using normal 3x3 techniques. So we can see this green has to go into this green slot right here. So you can see it's both green. So using a normal insertion algorithm, you just insert it. And see, you inserted it. Okay, so I'm going to look around and see this has to be red. So we find the red corner piece and insert it. Okay, now that we've done that, we have to insert a three-colored corner. So we see we need the green, red, and yellow. So we look around. Here's the green, red, and yellow. And we want to have either the, see how these are the two bottom colors, green and red? We want to have either green or red on the bottom of this. So we can see we have red on the bottom of this. And using normal 3x3 techniques, you insert it the correct way, like this. You don't want to insert it the wrong way, like this. You want to insert it the correct way. Okay, now we're going to turn it around and do the next part. And see, this corner is in, but it's misoriented correctly. So I'll show you an example here where, see how these are not, these are the bottom colors, and one of those are not facing the bottom on this corner. Well, what you want to do with that is just basically a normal 3x3 case where you lift it up, out of the way, turn it back, and then lift this down. And as we can see, now the red's at the bottom. The red has to go here, so we just insert it. Okay, now that we have our whole first layer done, you want to move on to your second layer. And this, again, is like 3x3. Okay, so we want to insert the blue one. So now when you want to find the correct edge that goes in here, you want to find an edge that does not, it's not flush with this right here. And we can see this is flush with this piece, and so is this. But if we turn it here, you can see this is not flush. So we could insert it using the normal algorithm that inserts it. So this has to go to the left. We do U prime, L prime, U, L, U, F, U prime, and F prime. And you can see it inserts correctly. Okay, so now we have to look here. So we have to have a yellow one. This is flush, so it's incorrect. But if we turn it here, it's correct. Now we can see this has to go into the right. So we do U, R, U prime, U prime, F prime, U, and F. Okay, so now we inserted these two edges. We have to insert the next edge. So we look for a red piece. Red piece. Is this flush? Yes. It's not flush right here. And this may be confusing since there's two colors in the center, but you just want to see if it's flush with the center. See, this is not flush, so that's good, so let's go to the right. So we insert it again. Okay, now that we've done that, we have to insert a green one, the last edge for our second layer. Look for the green. Is this flush? No. So we insert it. This time it has to go to the left. Okay, now that we've done that, you want to build your cross. So what you're doing when you're building your cross, you may see, oh, you have one edge. That looks like a parity, but it's not. So what happens is if you either have no edges correct or just one edge correct, you do the soon algorithm. So if you do no edges correct, you just do it from anywhere. But if you do have one edge correct, you hold it right here. And this being on the left, this as the R face, and this piece just being right here, and you want to do the soon. R, U, R prime, U, R, U2, R prime. Now that was an easy case. It just solved it. But sometimes you run into a case like this. Okay, here we go. Sorry that took a little bit. I'll cut that part out. So what you have is you have an L right here. You could have an L or you could have a line. So if you have a line, you do the same algorithm and you hold it from here using this as the front face. And if you have an L, you hold it also from here. So the L's like this as the front face. And this would be the front face, and you hold the L like this. So you do the normal cross algorithm. Front, up, right, up inverted, right inverted, front inverted. And see, we have one here. So we do the soon, using this as the R face. And it will solve. Sometimes you'll have to do it multiple times. And like I said, the line, you hold it across like this, and then do the algorithm, this being the line, and even L. You do it from the same place as if this is the L, and you do the algorithm from here. Okay, so now this part is just like a 3x3. You want to look for correct corners. So what you want to do is use the normal permutation algorithm to get corners correct. We have none correct right now, so we'll just do that algorithm from anywhere. U, R, U prime, L prime, U, R prime, U prime, L. Okay, now we see we have one in. One of these. So you want to hold it on the front and do the algorithm from there. If we had a correct one of these, you do it from here, using this as the U and this is the R. But since we have one correct, we're going to hold it here and do it U, R, U prime, L prime, U, R prime, U prime, L. And we can see we have to do it one more time and do it again. Now on this, you could never run into a case on like a megamorphics where you have two swapped. That and two that are correct. So what you want to do now is just orient them. So basically, this has to be oriented. So using this as the R face, use the right inverted, down inverted, right down algorithm that you use a lot. So right inverted, down inverted, right down, right inverted, down inverted, right down. And we turn it around and do that algorithm again. And we can see, you solve the puzzle. And like I showed in my previous tutorials, if you orient both of these corners right here, and it's still incorrect the bottom layer, you have to orient one of these. And like I said, I've said that many times before. These two oriented correctly, this bottom layer still messed up, just go onto one of these. And never move your whole cube around when you're doing that algorithm, just the top layer. To get the piece that you have to orient to the spot that you were just doing it on. Okay, so that's pretty much it for how you solve it. You start off by aligning the centers and, yeah, align them with the correct colors. Insert the edges into it to make a cross. Insert the corners for the first layer. Then you insert the edges with the second layer, making sure that they are not flush when you're inserting them, or it will go in backwards. Solve the cross using the soon and that algorithm for the cross. And then you permute them using the 3x3 algorithm and orient them using the 3x3 algorithm. And like I said, again, if you have two oriented and one incorrect, I mean the bottom layer is still incorrect, you have to orient one of these small ones right here. So basically this is just a 3x3 shape mod, and it's using all 3x3 algorithms and techniques. So you should know how to solve a 3x3 before attempting this, and it won't be too much harder. It's always a bit harder to figure out at first, but then after a while you'll get the hang of it and start solving it. Okay, so that's about it for this video. Next video will be a megamorphics tutorial, a full tutorial on how to solve it, excluding the parodies because I made a video on that already. And that's about it. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more content, and stay tuned for future videos. And have a good day. Bye.